Today in the news, we've got Navi drivers, I talk about Navi for a few minutes, and Intel ignores our needs. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with AMD. It looks like Navi drivers are getting closer and closer to completion. Phoronix.com saw some commits on the AMD GPU LLVM's backend. Basically, it means changes are being made in AMD's GPU libraries, and they're referencing GFX 1010. That is the Navi Identifier, or name. According to Phoronix, AMD is probably working through the legal review for the code. This is usually the last step before the code can be published publicly by AMD. The driver being so close to completion like that gives us more evidence or hope that Navi will be ready for Computex. Speaking of Navi, and this is just me making an observation here, but with the GTX 16 series pretty much all laid out on the table, don't you think all those Navi GPUs we heard about in the leaks make a little more sense now? I mean, the only thing I think might change is the price and the name, because both of them can be changed very easily. I mean, personally, I'd probably add 10 to 20% to the price that we saw in the leaks. But let's revisit them for a second, but adjust the leaks to the current cards. Also, I'm gonna keep the leaked names for the Navi GPUs. I know they're terrible, but we need them. So you could get RX 580 performance for around $130 to $150, and it would beat the GTX 1650. Then you could get GTX 1070 performance for around $200 to $250, and it would match or beat the GTX 1660 Ti. And you could pay around $300 for RTX 2060 performance, but without ray tracing. Those comparisons are essentially the exact same as the older leaks, just with newer hardware and prices. So what do you think? Back then, we didn't even know about the GTX 16 series, or even the RTX 2060 for that matter. All we thought was that Navi was too good to be true. But now that we have Nvidia's offerings in front of us, we can see what kind of performance a budget GPU can offer us right now. The only thing I hope AMD doesn't do is use the Nvidia pricing scheme to justify their prices. Like if they were to put the RX 3080 at $350 just because it would match the green team's price. What do you guys think about this? We're pretty much half a year past those leaks, and as time goes on, do you feel like AMD could pull it off? Let me know down below. Then we have Intel. It looks like their Q1 earnings call of 2019 unfortunately brings bad news for those of us who thought we would see a 10 nanometer desktop SKU this year. During the financial results call, the company did confirm that they had started to distribute some Ice Lake engineering samples to OEMs and system integrators, but it looks like those are just Ice Lake U SoCs for ultra portable devices. This would be the first round of processors based on the Sunny Cove core design, which is the first major change since Intel's 2015 Skylake processors. Intel CEO Bob Swan did mention that at least those Ice Lake U low power SoCs would be on the shelves for the holiday season this year. So if you wanted a lightweight notebook and you wanted to wait, 10 nanometer Sunny Cove will be there for you. Intel is also going to prioritize their enterprise segment over their desktop, which is understandable since AMD has been pretty active in the space. In fact, Ice Lake U will be followed by Ice Lake SP, which would be the first Xeon line with Sunny Cove cores. So far, there are absolutely no indications of Intel putting Sunny Cove into our desktops just yet. If I had to guess, I think we might not even see Sunny Cove on our desktop PCs at all. We might skip straight to Willow Cove, which is slated for 2020. This year, we'll probably see two, maybe three new unlocked CPUs for desktops based on Comet Lake. Something like a 10 core with hyper-threading and another one without. And maybe the rebirth of a 6 core with 12 thread CPU. I'm pretty sure Intel will create a whole new refresh generation out of those CPUs since there isn't much room left in the 9900 naming scheme. Unless the 10 core 20 thread one is going to be called the 9999K or something like that. With the Zen 2 demo at CES showing an 8 core Ryzen performing slightly better than an 8-core Intel at a lower power consumption, I really don't see Intel being able to make a dent into Ryzen 3000. This is one of the reasons why I don't think Intel will refresh the whole line of CPUs this year, instead just focusing on the higher core count stuff. Although the 8th gen to 9th gen transition did bring a complete refresh down to the i3s, so you never know. Anyways, Intel, good luck after Ryzen 3000. So I had a lot of fun talking about those two subjects, but I still want to hear from you guys. So leave your comments down below. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, my dudes, and I'll see you on the next one.